everyone, and welcome back to a new building tutorial. This one we'll be making about mushrooms, submitted, the idea submitted by Pixel. Anyway, when we finished it, it should look something like this. But you can actually change the textures, of course, to make it look a bit different. So what I did here is change the stem to logs. And this is the ID, and also change the yellow stained clay to pink stained clay to sort of give it a different look. And here I just changed the stem of it to acacia again. And all the comments for the video will be down in the description. And let's start. Start off with already a layer of sponge. I already placed it down because it's just a bit easier to recognize for me where everything is. And there is a schematic download available, so you can try it out yourself or compare it to your build. And as you can see me here placing all the sponge blocks for the stem, it will be changed later with a brush to the all-sided mushroom block. But this here is quite hard actually. I failed at this several times. The top part is the most easiest, but getting the shape right here is quite hard, as you can see me here looking back to my original design. And just deleting some, you just need to get it just right. I thought when I was making this, I thought it was right. It's just a bit almost perfect. And as you can see me there, I changed the brush. This was recorded using the replay mod actually, because I forgot to record that I had the replay mod on. So that's why you don't see my hotbar. Anyway, I'm just continuing to build here. I thought it would be high enough, but it's just a little bit too low. Otherwise it will just look a bit weird at the top. So now I'm just trying to get a sort of circular shape, not a perfect circle, because that just looks weird. And placing blocks on the top, making it look good, adjusting it a little bit. And then I just go down. I'm just gonna finish another circle, and then I'm going to go down two blocks. Okay, still need to finish it. This is actually speed up by quite a bit. I think it's 50% faster than normal, something around that. And I'm just going to look at the other one, and here, as you can see here, I'm just placing blocks underneath the outer ring, and placing even more blocks going all the way down to sort of get a more organic feel, so it's not really blocky but also not too circular, because then it just looks weird and almost like a spear, which you don't want to have, of course, because if you just look at it in real life, it's not a perfect circle, of course. And as you can see here, I'm just smoothing it out and finishing the bottom part here, and then we're quite close to being done actually. Okay, still placing some blocks, it's just a bit hard to get it correct. It took me quite some tries to get this recording, because I failed at it several times in one go. And now I'm just gonna place yellow stained clay all around underneath the final layer. And I'm just going to place the white dots now and adjust that a little bit. Yeah, I just want to adjust it all the way. You don't really want to have them several parts, but if you see something is not good, just change it right away, otherwise you might forget it. And here I'm just placing three blocks of white hardened clay every time. You don't really want to have more than that, perhaps for the top, as I'm about to do, because it doesn't really look good with four, as you can see me there trying to figure it out a little bit. What looks good, because yeah, the stain so open with just one block doesn't really look as good as with a block next to it. Anyway, here I'm doing the top with four blocks. And you also want to randomize it a lot so it's not a lot of dots on one side and nothing on the other side. So make sure you do that. And this is about it done. If you enjoyed this kind of quick tutorial, I was talking the whole time, getting better at this. Anyway, hope you enjoyed it, leave a like for more, and also subscribe for more, of course. Bye.